Welcome to the channel. Today we're going to be looking at another sensor that the guys at Apollo sent over for review with the MSR2 motion sensor, which comes with built-in lux, UV, temperature, pressure, and optional CO2 sensor built-in. This is one of the smallest microwave motion sensors on the market and is the successor to the already tiny MSR1 motion sensor, which is no longer sold. We'll walk through the features, the various different mounting options they provide, how you connect the MSR2 to Home Assistant, and how the MSR2 performs. So let's dive into the super small world of the MSR2. The Apollo MSR2 comes in a robust 3D printed plastic housing, allowing access to the electronics that you will need if you want to select the different mounting options. More on that later. In comparison to the MSR1, the MSR2 is smaller on the face, but is a few millimeters thicker. Not that you would notice, as this is really a tiny sensor. This super small microwave sensor uses the LD2410 microwave motion sensor from Hylink Electronics and uses the 24 GHz range. As you would expect, this is one of the smallest microwave motion sensors on the market. Apollo needed to use this sensor to keep their size of the MSR2 down to 40mm long by 23mm wide by 15mm deep. It has a reasonably long range of 5m and detects over a 60 degree angle detection with a single object detection. So this is ideal for detecting motion as small as you breathing while watching TV or sitting still in a study. The luminosity and UV measurements are provided by a light on optical sensor that reports to have a light sensitivity of 0.1 lux to 150,000 lux. Then there is a temperature and pressure sensor that is provided by digital sensors with a reported temperature accuracy of 0.5 degrees Celsius and a pressure sensitivity of 0.5 pascals per Kelvin. Let's see if the accuracy is validated and how Apollo account for the internal electronic heat buildup that might prove to be a challenge for calibration. The optional carbon dioxide tracking is provided by the Sensirion SCD4X. Now this is the same sensor that is used in the Air 1 from Apollo and proved to be accurate and reliable. So I'm sure this will be true here also. This is a great option and one I would highly recommend for home safety. And finally, as the MSR2 is driven by an ESP32C3 Mini, which offers Wi-Fi but also Bluetooth connectivity, so you can implement Bluetooth tracking through YAML code configuration, making it super flexible for you if you have not implemented this functionality. I'll put links to all the datasheets in the comments below. Apollo had an engineering challenge here. With a sensor that's so small, the cable that powers the device makes it difficult to mount as it's so light, so it needs great mounting options. Apollo offer four different options to meet your every need. Firstly, there is the no-cost option of the device itself that comes with a 3M sticker that you can mount as you wish. This obviously has limitations and might not fit with your needs. Secondly, there is a costed option of a traditional base plate and a ball and socket interchangeable backplate. This is probably the option that most of you will go with, as it allows for simple location and adjustment of direction. Then there are two unique mounting options. First of these is a cost option with a double-ended USB adapter that allows the MS2 to be connected to the top of a USB power adapter. Apollo can even supply this to you, at least in the American markets. This is both unique and highly adaptable sensor mounting that capitalizes on the sensor's small size. The second of these is a cost option for a USB adapter that connects to an internal socket inside of the MSR2 and allows power to be provided through an interchangeable backplate. This allows the sensor to again be USB power brick mounted, but this time from the front of the power adapter. So whichever way you want to mount the sensor, Apollo has you covered. Just make sure you decide on the location and the mounting option before you purchase, as these mounting options beyond the 3M sticker are cost options and you'll need to select on purchase. Now, as the MSR2 is an ESP home device, there are multiple ways to connect it to Home Assistant. We'll be connecting the MSR2 via Wi-Fi to our phone, configuring it to connect to our Wi-Fi network, then configuring the device in Home Assistant. I'm using an iPhone, but the steps should be the same as an Android device. Navigate to Settings, then Wi-Fi. Now plug in your MSR2 to a USB-C power adapter. You should now see a Wi-Fi hotspot for the Apollo MSR2. Select this and connect to it. Now sometimes this automatically takes you to the login screen for the ESP home device. But if not, then open a browser, in my case Safari. Enter the URL for 192.168.4.1 and press return. This will bring you to the login screen for the MSR2. Select your 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi network. Type in your Wi-Fi password and press save. The MSR2 will now disconnect from your phone and connect to your Wi-Fi. Now we can move over to Home Assistant. You'll notice that a new notification has appeared. Navigate to the Notifications section. Now select Check It Out. This will navigate to the Integrations. You should now see your new MSR2 has been discovered. If the MSR2 does not show up, then try refreshing your screen or restarting Home Assistant. Now press Configuration for the MSR2. Home Assistant will ask if you want to add the ESP Home node of the MSR2. Press Submit. Home Assistant will report success. Now optionally give your MSR2 an area and press Finish. Now let's go and see what entities are made available to us with the MSR2. Search for and select ESP Home. Press the device hyperlink for the MSR2. If you're enjoying the video, then maybe this is a good time to hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. And if you want to get early access to videos, then maybe become a channel member. The sensors that are exposed are the same as the MSR1, just in a smaller package. In controls, you can calibrate the CO2 sensor. However, I don't have the CO2 sensor in this review unit. But as I said, for home safety, I would strongly encourage you to consider this and build automations around it. Then you get a really cool LED in the unit. Although this is a really small addition to the unit, it gives you so much more functionality. You can set automations that turn certain colors based on certain sensor values, or when the UV goes above a certain threshold, or just to remind you to put the bins out. In the sensor section, you get measurements for pressure and temperature, noting that the temperature has an offset. This allows you to calibrate this to overcome the heat buildup from the ESP32. So although not super accurate, in my testings, I found that once calibrated, it was accurate to within a degree. The pressure, on the other hand, I found to be very accurate, reporting the same as the Air 2 and also my Witboy. Then you get the luminosity and UV index measurements. I think these are more of an indication than an accurate level. I mean, this is not an externally rated device, and there doesn't seem to be much of a UV threat inside my house, even in Australia. Then comes the star of the attraction, the radar detection. Now, Apollo are excellent at self-help guides, unlike some companies I could mention. Heading over to the Apollo wiki site, links in the description, for an in-depth tutorial on tuning your new sensor. The radar motion tracking can be configured for 3 zones. These are distance from the sensor and not positional in the field of detection. Follow the excellent Apollo tutorial for instructions on how to do this. But the controls for this are listed in the bottom of the settings. In my testing, this proved to be very accurate, as you would expect. A user case for this might be if you want to turn on the desk lights when you are sitting at your desk, but do not want these lights to turn on when somebody passes the desk, so to detect movement close but not far away. And finally, while you have been tuning and configuring your MSR2, you might have noticed that a new notification has popped up for a Bluetooth device. This capitalizes on the ESP32 Bluetooth module inside of the Apollo MSR2. You can now use this Bluetooth for tracking and can be configured in YAML. I won't go into the specifics in this video, but the fact this is offered as an option is amazing. So what do I think about the Apollo MSR2? Should you buy it, consider it, or skip it? Well, if you're looking for one of the smallest and inconspicuous radar motion sensors on the market that has a mounting option for all user cases, then buy it. Links in the description to the MSR2 and all mounting options. It's super simple to set up, offers an excellent radar motion sensor, has additional sensors that can be used for automations, and importantly, is actively supported by Apollo with excellent documentation and support. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, then maybe support the channel by liking and subscribing. And if you want access to early content, then maybe consider becoming a member. Until the next one, let's keep trying to avoid those motion sensors.